Hi everyone, Christine Espinoza.
Hi, Carlos Daniel.
Carlos Daniel. I am at the Phoenix Dream Center today, looking around and getting a tour from Carlos to find out a little bit more about this awesome organization, which I'm collecting donations for this Saturday at our Shred-a-thon at McDonald Ranch. But I wanted Carlos to tell you guys a little bit about what is the Phoenix Dream Center.
Yeah, so the Phoenix Dream Center, we have three goals. The first goal is to end human trafficking. We're fighting drug addiction and we're ending childhood hunger. And so right now we're in the first quarter of 2021, we're outfitting six new rooms for our human trafficking recovery program, which we call Hope Wing. And we have a lot of different needs in that area, from room remodels. We have in-kind donations for Christmas for the human trafficking survivors.
Oh, that's right, because Christmas is coming up.
Yep.
So they need stuff for children and for the women and men here?
Yeah, so one third of the women here are actually pregnant or have babies, and so children's toys are always accepted, winter clothes, and then there's a lot of different outreaches we can be a part of as well.
Awesome, that's great. And I actually, at McDowell Mountain Ranch this Saturday, we're setting up a big collection box, and we have a list of all the items that we're asking for this weekend, so you can bring them by the community center, and then I'll set up another donation center after that, because I would love to start collecting things for the holidays to get them some presents for their little ones for Christmas.
Yep.
Okay, so tell me, give me a couple easy ways if someone feels compelled and wants to donate either time or money or items, give me a couple things that they can do to help the
Dream
Center.
So there's three main ways. One, if you want to volunteer, you can sign up online. You can volunteer in Hope Wing, in our Life Recovery Program. You can volunteer at Outreaches. You can actually also volunteer virtually. We have a program there.
Do you need to have a special skill set to volunteer? Or can you just be, you know, someone who wants to give their time?
Yeah, it can honestly, it can be anyone. I know some people who they feel their special skill is organizing things. So they can organize a donation drive at their business or at their school or different organizations. And some people, it's, you know, just helping out at different areas, from the outreaches we serve, so giving families food boxes, helping at an after-school program. Some people, it's, you know, organizing something on social media. And so there's a lot of different skills, and, you know, just be signing up and giving us your information.
And if people want to come here and actually, you know, hands-on volunteer, can they do that as well?
They can. There's different types of, so if it's for Hope Wing, it'd be because it's for human trafficking survivors. There'd be a stronger clearance, and there would also be a time commitment for certain things. Mm-hmm. And then for the other areas, there's less commitments as it moves away from the trafficking survivors.
Okay. And donation-wise, what are your top donation items that you're wanting to collect?
So right now, because it is getting colder in Phoenix after so long, I'm thinking we're needing some sweaters. Okay. For those in the programs. And then,
is this men, women, and children?
Yes.
Okay.
All three. And then we're actually right now, of all things, water bottles is a need for our outreaches.
You know,
when we serve the homeless at different outreaches, and we need water bottles for that.
Okay, water bottles. Okay, good. Yeah. So if you can't get down here but want to maybe set up a donation station at your place of business or, you know, another place where you attend often, your gym or whatever, that would be a great thing to do easy. Collect water bottles.
And then we also, we're accepting, whether it's the toys for the babies or it's diapers. So we're always accepting diapers as well.
Never have enough diapers.
Yeah.
Okay, well, thank you so much, Carlos.
Thank you.
And if you want to come by, they're so gracious with their time, you can come by and get a tour and see it yourself. It's really awesome and inspiring to see how many people come together and made these beautiful living spaces for the men and women here to be in a safe place and a healthy environment. So thanks.
Thank you, Christine.
Everyone who's helping here. And thanks for watching.
Bye.
Bye.